all of a sudden I'm not as nervous as I was. I'm here to go. Yeah, I'm probably gonna start right on that piano, but we'll see. Hi.
And if you're ready, I'll say a little welcome to you.
Okay.
Thank you, Theodore. Hello and welcome. Very glad to have you here together today, both those who are gathered in this beautiful space and those who are joining today online. We're grateful for the chance with the combination of both technology and our volunteers and others who make it possible for us to continue to gather in new ways around music as we enjoy the gifts of those who are part of our wider region and community, and those who are able to join in all of those ways to be part of our listening audience and part of what we do here. I'm John Sal. I'm the Director of Music Ministries here at Abington Presbyterian Church, and one of the real highlights of that role for me is getting also to be a colleague and a host for lots of different kinds of programs, part of the Music at Abington series. This month of February, when we are really grateful to partner with our local Philadelphia chapter of the American Guild of Organists, is a wonderful chance to present area and regional organists who are part of that chapter as part of a larger collective of spaces all around the Philadelphia area, taking turns and sharing the role to just gather for these noontide concerts each Tuesday. Next month, for the month of March, I believe St. David's in Radnor is the regular host. And so I know that that is quite a jaunt from here if you're here local as an Abington listener, if you're an avid organ enthusiast and you follow these recitals all over the Philadelphia region. They will be very glad to have you there as well. But for those of you who are here local and those online as well, we had one Tuesday that was canceled or postponed, I guess, for weather, right? You remember our very snowy Tuesday when the lot still had 4 inches of snow at 11:30, and we were not here on that day. We are adding an extra bonus Tuesday, and Eric Meyer, who is the organist here, and my colleague, graciously has agreed to just delay and repeat his plans for that performance next week instead. So please do come back next week and you get one extra, one bonus Tuesday this year, delayed for weather earlier in the month. And to those who are part of the wider Philadelphia chapter region, I know that they would be thrilled to have you at St. David's in Radnor for the month of March as well. A wonderful program today. I hope you picked one up at the door. You'll get to hear a rich variety of some pieces that reflect all different kinds, eras, and styles of writing, those based on chorales, those that are pieces to invite you in, pieces to inspire you and to lift your spirits and your heart as well. It's a real pleasure for me today to get to introduce a new friend and colleague. And one of the delights of this series over many years of hosting is folks who I have known by their reputation from connection to wonderful music ministries like Tindley Temple, those who I have known because we might have shared along the way either teachers or colleagues somewhere and having worked together. Makes a great chance for folks that we're all busy often in our work at the same time, whether that's on Sunday mornings or with concerts. And so these recitals form a wonderful opportunity to get to meet, to work with, and form new collegial friendships with folks that I haven't had the chance to make music with before. So all this last week, I have been enjoying today's recital when I hear a few notes drift down the hall during registration and practice sessions while I've been at my desk, and you're in for a real treat today. It's an honor and a privilege to introduce Theodore Thomas. He's a retired music teacher from the Philadelphia school system, but also a wonderful part of the organ community, the AGO community, and the church music community here in Philadelphia. I won't read to you the full bio, but his bio is on the back of the program. Please look there for the wonderful artists he's had a chance to collaborate with over his service and career in the music and church communities here in this area, and also some wonderful connections that you will see connected to this place, to the rest of Philadelphia, and our rich organ and music community. The last thing I would just mention if you are an organ enthusiast is coming up in this coming week or so, the historic sacred spaces of Philadelphia, there are a series of organ recitals all through the first week of March. If you're interested in that, I'll be glad to give you more information about it. I won't take time to do that from the podium, but some really exciting programs of all different sorts in a number of the historic instruments and churches and faith communities in and around Philadelphia. So a wonderful chance for those of you who know and love those instruments and that literature to hear them in a new way. A final welcome to our young guests from the lunch bunch in the nursery school. We're glad you're here today and we look forward to sharing music together. I hope you'll put your hands together and help me say a welcome to Theodore Thomas, and we'll let music play on.
I'd like to say that I want to thank Eric for inviting me here, and this is something I haven't done in a while, a recital, so I'm a little nervous, but I see so many people that love me here, so I'm feeling a little better now. To assist me with page turning is Dr. Leon, who is also a wonderful organist, Leon Burroughs, and his wife is in the audience. Thank you so much for your attendance, and I'm glad it's over.